Hey guys, welcome to Legal Matters with Yen again. And this video is about the story of the Brevnov Monastery in Prague. Here in the Czech Republic, pubs or pub is one of the biggest trend here in the Czech Republic. Here, the Czech Republic is huge to beers. The locals love to drink beer, and most of the locals goes to the pubs, talk with their friends in there, and together with that they cannot get along without drinking some beer. So this is about the environment or the surroundings on the history of the of Brevnov Monastery here in Prague. Last weekend my family went to hiking and we decided to visit this this monastery.
Oh, it's a motorcycle
for, you know, to visit this monastery and also to see the surroundings, because it's really the surroundings is really cool.
It's beautiful, guys.
For a family picnic.
It's gorgeous.
You know, just to rest there and relax and enjoy the view of the, see the little creatures of these ducks on the pond. And the history of this monastery is that actually it is a church. It is run by the monks back in 1900s. It became the hub of the monks, and then later on down the line when the Velvet Revolutions ended up, the church was rebuilt again. And there's a brewery in the side of the church. Until now, that brewery still exists, and also become the restaurant and become the hub of this local people, of these locals around the area, around Brevnov Monastery. Just a very quick history about it is that by the church was, Brevnov Monastery was founded by Saint Adelbert, which is the second bishop of Prague back in the 900s. The first Benedictine male monastery in Bohemia is the oldest traditions of beer brewing in the Czech Republic. Brewing of the beer back then it's kind of a traditions for the Czech people or for the locals. And because of that, it became the trend all over Czech Republic, and people are making some fun about it, brewing their own beer. And back then it's got interrupted many times because of the problems back then, the World War II, the Velvet Revolutions, the communism era. So that got interrupted until just recently, back in the 90s, it became, after the Velvet Revolutions, it got rebuilt, and the business continues, and it become huge, especially because of the a very unique place that is a monastery brewing their own beer and selling it to the local, and locals come by and buy it, and then sitting in there having their own barbecue together with their beers, together with their family, and you know. And the business was run by the bishops as well as the priests and the monks back then. But then after the revolutions, the monks were deported. This is a disclaimer talk. On my research, it said that the monks were deported back to their original place, because when they arrived here, those monks were travelers, and then they came here to hide, and they started to do this, you know, this kind of traditions. This is back in the 900 years ago, so before World War I, World War II, the Velvet Revolutions, before that, way long ago. So that's the very brief history of this Brevnov Monastery brewery. And other than that, it still exists right now. People love it. The business is growing, even though it's on a kind of a tight situation right now. But it seems like the business is growing, as I saw it in there.
No, that's only me.
I remember last time when I was there. It's not just
hey, Birdie.
Not this recently. The vividly that I remember, it was winter. We went to this restaurant in this monastery brewery pub. When I get in, because it's very cold and it's snowing outside, all you can notice and feel the greatness is that the fireplace itself. The fireplace is working inside, and it's very cool to get in, to be in that kind, to be in that time back then. It was snowing, and I remembered I ordered a soup, a bowl of soup. And I don't drink beer though, so I am more on wine. So I ordered a hot wine, I guess, if I remember that, or a coffee, I don't remember, but I know I had some hot beverage down there back then. And the area was really cool, fireplace all over. The ambience is, the interior is kind of very rusticy, and I don't have the picture for that. And recently when my family went there, it's hard to get in because it's the setup is really laid back. It's closed, but you can buy some drinks, some, you know, things like that, but you have to sit outside, so you really cannot get and feel in the inside of it. It's just you know, bringing back the vivid memory back then. So I would like to go back there again, especially this coming winter. Hopefully their fireplace still in there. So other than that, yes, still ran by the bishop. By the priest in there told you the histories that started by the monks who are travelers and went there back in the 900 years ago, and they start doing this. It was a church, run by the monks, and the monks were hiding there because of whatever reason. And for them to survive, aside for the church, they also have this, they started to build this this pub, and they do their brewing of the beers itself in there. And until it continues traditions, the next generations. And then back in their Velvet Revolutions, all those monks, because they were getting the relationship of the other monks that become because people will go there, and you know, so this Brevnov Monastery is accepting tourist guide, tourist tour in there. You can do some appointment if you want to see what's going on inside, the history back then, the very clear history of the place. They do some, you know, the tourist guide, and they will explain and tell you how they do their routine in there, their daily lives and their daily activity in there. Aside for the interior and the inside of the restaurant, you can see also when you go outside the area, you will see there's a very nice band. Surely it is a man-made, and there are little creatures there. Surely there's fishes probably, and there's ducks that are looking healthy. And around the fun was, there's a tree benches that you can sit down there and have picnic, read books, and or just relax. There's also a trail to do biking, and then on the other side you can see the loaded with trees. These white trees was fascinated me because it's very cool. So I had some pictures in here, as you can see. There is really, really cool, really, really very relaxing. And I guess it's just a matter of, you know, how you feel it, how you can, you know, you can comply that day if you want some relaxations. I guess I am recommending for you to come this place. If you want to go by yourself, just bring your book, read, and relax, rejuvenate yourself, think about something or whatever, or have fun with your friends and have some picnic or walk around under these wonderful trees, because it's spring right now. It's still the color of these trees were white, and that's what is the eye fall catching. So that really caught my attention in there. So yeah, I it's just sad that I don't have, you know, I don't have the pictures of the interior of the pub, because I lost my pictures back then. That was like probably like maybe five to eight years ago, and when I was there just recently last weekend, it's sure far from what I could vividly remember from the first time I was there. So as I'm telling you, because it is and because it's COVID and all the, you can only buy outside, I mean you can only you cannot get in, it's just everything is out of nowhere, the interior is different, so there's no fireplace and things like that. Then you can only order the hot beverage outside or beer and bring it outside, or you can bring that to the park, it's up to you. But hopefully perhaps when I come back there the next time, hopefully that everything will settle down and everything gets back to normal, so I can show you the interior itself. So for now guys, that's all for today, and that's all for this blog. And as I am saying, this pub here is highly recommended. It is one of the top rated top 10 in the most visited pubs in Prague. So if you come by, if you happen to come by, please don't hesitate to visit this place. It's very easy to go this place. Just hop on number 22 can bring you anywhere in Prague. For now guys, that's it, and see you later again. Bye, thank you for watching. Legal Matters with Jen, sign out.